In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create a proper diagonal mullion in Revit. So if you don't know, unfortunately, Revit doesn't offer a true diagonal mullion. However, there is a workaround and a solution, and I'm going to be showing you just how to do it. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours of content where I talk about all of the interesting and important Revit topics. Okay, so now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And as you can see, here I am in Revit. I'm just using the default metric template just because it has the curtain wall, which I prefer. So what I'll do now is go here to the architecture tab, go to the wall tool, and then let's pick out the curtain wall storefront. And then let's set it to go to level 2, click apply, and then let's make a couple of segments. I'm just going to hit the space key to flip it around. And then we can create something that looks like this. We can also open up the 3D view just to see what that looks like. And as you can see, by default, you're going to have regular mullions, which kind of overlap over each other. Now, this is quite annoying and I don't like it. And you can add some corner mullions that Revit offers. They look like this. I find them really ugly, so I'm not going to be showing you how to use those. But if you're interested in how to set them up, I have an entire video on that topic, which I'm going to link up in the cards above so you can check it out. So now, to create our corner mullion, first we need to get some measurements. So I'm going to go here into level 1, zoom in a little bit, and let's change the scale to something like 1 to 20 so we can see things a bit better. And then I'm going to add a simple aligned dimension here by using the tab key and just place it here to get the width and depth of all of these mullions. So we have 150 for the depth and then 50 for the width. Okay, so with that information, I'm going to then go here to File, New, and then create a new family. I'm just going to go one folder back so I can get the metric templates, and then here I want to pick out the metric profile mullion. Hit open. Of course, if you're using imperial units, feel free to use that. Anyways, here we have our corner mullion. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to come in here and then let's use the reference planes to add some sort of structure. So here I'm going to go to the reference plane, add one vertical plane like this, and I'm going to add a couple of horizontal ones like so. Hit the escape key a couple of times and then let's add some dimensions. So one dimension will go from here to here, one will go like this, and this will be an equalizing or EQ dimension, and then I'm going to have one like this. Hit the escape key a few times and then let's switch this to 1 to 5 so these dimensions are just a little bit smaller. And then what I'll do next is I'm going to set these dimensions as parameters. So you do that by selecting the dimension, you go to label dimension. If you don't have any parameters here, as I don't, you go here to create new parameter, and then we can name this. So this will be mullion half width. You can leave it as a type parameter, then click OK. This one, again, I'm just going to set it as a parameter, and this will be the mullion depth. Here, you can also leave it as a type parameter, and then just click OK. Okay, moving forward, let's now add the actual dimensions for the width and depth. So if we remember here, it's 150 and 50. So here, if I open up the family types, it's going to give me those parameters. So mullion half width is actually half of 50, so that's going to be 25. And then for the mullion depth, that's going to be 150. We can hit apply and OK. And now the dimensions have been adjusted. Now, moving forward, what I'm going to do is add some additional reference lines or reference planes. So let's go here to create, go to reference plane, and then let's add two more on top and bottom. Hit the escape key a couple of times. Again, let's add an EQ dimension here, just like that. Hit EQ and then one total dimension. So the reason why we need this is because this is also going to be a parameter, and this will be the diagonal depth parameter. This can also stay as a type parameter, then you want to click OK. And the reason why we have this parameter is because here in level one, if we take a look at this, this distance from here to here is obviously smaller than the diagonal distance. So we need to have a larger parameter for the diagonal depth. Now we need to have an actual formula, and it's actually quite simple. So with a little math, we come to that the mullion diagonal depth is going to be mullion depth. So we can just copy and paste times 1.41, and then we can hit apply. Okay, so with that all set up, now we can move forward and we can actually start sketching out our mullion. Now, this says half mullion, and the reason for that is because we're going to be modeling this as half mullion. So we're going to have actually two halves, which are hosted on two walls that come to a corner. So what I'll do here is I'm simply going to go here to create lines. I'm going to pick the rectangle and just place it like this, and hit the locks on all of these. Hit the escape key a few times, then we're actually going to unlock this. So hold the control key, and then you can move this up to something like, let's see. Okay, so here I'm just going to remove this constraint. So this should be at 45 degrees, and then this one should kind of come like that. Perfect. Okay, so we have that corner. And then what I'm going to do is just add another dimension just to make sure that this stays in place. And then this will also be half mullion. And that's going to give us the correct kind of 45 degree angle. So we have this almost done. The only thing that we need to add is here, if I go back to level one here in the project, you can see that the glass, so this is the glass, it comes here up to the mullion. So when we have this diagonal mullion, it has to cut in at a 45 degree angle. And we actually need to make that cut inside of our half mullion. So to make that cut, what I'm going to do is go here to create, go to a reference plane and place one 45 degree reference plane here at the center, just because I've been playing around with this and I know the dimensions. What I can do now is go back, create another reference plane here, and then I can set a dimension here, and I know that this distance should be 37. So then once we have this kind of marked out, I can come in here with create align, and then I want this to go like that. So this is basically marking out the center of our glass here. So if I come back here, I know that this should be 12.5. Why 12.5? Well, if I go back here and if I come to glass, I can measure it. And then we can say, okay, this is 25. So half of that is 12.5. So that's why I used that here. And then this distance should be at 25 exactly. Okay, so once we have this corner cut, now I can just go to modify. I can go to split element, SL is the shortcut, and make sure to check delete inner segment. And then you just cut from here to here. And perfect, we now have our mullion. Okay, so this is the right side, I guess you can say, so, or left. If I'm looking at it from the other side, kind of from the top back, let's call it left. I'm not really sure, but let's go with that. Okay, so now what I'll do is I'll go here to file, and then I'm just going to save as family, and I'm just going to save it on my desktop as the corner mullion left. Okay, so save that family, and then you want to load that into the project. So once this is loaded into the project, you can select the mullion, unpin it, then go here to the properties panel, go to edit type, go to duplicate, and let's call this one the corner mullion left. Click OK. And then in the construction under profile, you want to expand the drop menu and find that new profile mullion family, which we have created. Hit apply. And then let's see what that looks like. Okay, we can remove that dimension. And actually, let's remove all of these dimensions. So this is what that looks like. So we can now select that mullion again, go into edit type and just give it a rotation of, let's try 45. Nope. That should be minus 45, and perfect. So as you can see, it's fitting in perfectly right now. Now we have to do the same thing for the right side, left side, whatever. Let's go back here, and then I'm just going to select things like this, I think. Yeah, I think this should be it. Go to mirror, pick access, make sure that copy is turned off. Okay. Yeah, that should work. I should have probably mirrored this as well, just to keep that constraint. Okay, perfect. And then we can just add that dimension which was lost. I'm not really sure if I need it. Probably not, but let's have it in for good measure. Anyways, now once we have this created or changed, we can go File, Save As, Family, and then this will be quarter mullion right. Hit Save again, load that into the project, and now we can come to this mullion here, unpin it, and then set it to, or actually let's go to Edit Family, pick this one, duplicate, call this one right, click OK, and then let's here change the profile to right, hit apply, okay, and we just need to change the rotation, so this should be only 45, not minus 45. Hit apply, and this is what we get. And as you can see, now this is starting to take shape. Now, if I go to the 3D view and here, let's actually switch this to shaded. It's going to be a little bit easier to see. So we have that corner mullion, but we have a problem. The bottom mullions are stopping here, and then the glass is also stopping there. So it's not actually going up to the mullion itself. So what they'll do for the bottom mullions, it's actually an easy fix. You just select them and you have this little button, toggle mullion joins, and you just toggle it in here and for this mullion as well. And then they're going to connect. So we have that done. And then for glass, you just hit the tab key a few times, select the glass panel, unpin it, go to edit in place, and then in level one, for example, you can select it and you can just adjust it here, remove the constraints and hit finish. And then you just want to repeat that on the other side, unpin it, edit in place, and just extrude it. Remove constraints. Perfect. Hit finish. And now if I go to the 3D view, this is what that looks like. And now I just have to do the same thing here up above. So I'm just going to do that real quickly. And as you can see, this is what that looks like once it's finished up. And as you can see, it looks really elegant. It looks like a proper corner mullion. And this is something that you actually expect to see on office buildings and curtain walls and so on. Now here, if I go back to level one, it does look a little bit ugly, and using a profile wouldn't really help inside of the mullion or a detail image, just because it would only kind of cover half of it. So what you can do is just fix it up manually by going here to annotate and using a filled region, and then you can just sketch out the outline like so, and then this will give you something a bit more accurate. And of course you can use further detail elements to make it nicer if you want, just in the plan view. Now that's one of the limitations. Another limitation is, if you remember, with the glass panels we had to unpin those, so making any changes here is, it is going to break some stuff, so that's not good. So I would leave this kind of towards the end of the project, once you already know that you won't see any major changes happening, at least in the corners. And then I think that's it in terms of the limitations. So it does have some limitations, however it is possible to create that corner mullion, and this is how you do it. Now, if you want to get access to all of my Revit project files, so this file included, and the rest of my Revit project files, you can find all of that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above, and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.